So the next parameter is the calculation of the spin, that is the spin quantum number. So what is spin? Spin is basically the intrinsic angular momentum that a particle possess. So the intrinsic angular momentum is given by the formula under root of s into s plus 1 into h cross. So the s involved here in this formula of the orbital angular momentum is the spin quantum number, and it is taking the values of half integral for the fermions, and the value is 0 for the bosons. So the spin is having the half integral for fermions. So here we have drawn a chart consisting of the mesons and the baryons. So in the mesons we have pi type of mesons, k type of mesons and eta type of mesons. So the pi type of mesons are of three types: pi positive, pi naught and pi minus, where pi minus is the antiparticle of pi positive. And the k type of meson is of two, it consists of two particles, k positive and k naught, and it has its two antiparticles, that is k naught bar and k minus. And eta has one particle, that is eta naught. So the baryons consist of nucleons and hyperons. So nucleons are protons and neutrons and having its antiparticle, antiproton and antineutron. And in the hyperons we have the lambda particle, sigma particle, cascade or xi particle or the omega particle. So lambda is also one type, lambda naught, and the antiparticle lambda naught bar. And similarly sigma is of three types: sigma positive, sigma naught, sigma minus, and its three antiparticles: sigma plus bar, sigma naught bar and sigma minus bar. Similarly xi is of two types: xi neutral and xi minus, having its antiparticles xi positive and xi neutral bar. And the omega is having of the negative type and the antiparticle is of the positive type. So we can see here that the all the mesons are having a spin half, and whereas all the baryons are having a spin half, only the omega particle is having a spin of 3/2. So this means all the fermions are half integral spins and the mesons are zero integral spins. So this was our next parameter, that was the spin. Next we come to the isotopic spin or the isospin. So here we have already discussed about in the meson and the baryon families which were the particles and which were the antiparticles. So an isotopic spin space is just like the spin quantum number space in which the strong interactions are dealt, and the strong interactions remains invariant in the isotopic spin space also. So we know that we can calculate the multiplicity of a particular globe. So from the multiplicity we can calculate the isotopic spin also. So the multiplicity of the nuclear interacting particle, here is a line, multiplicity of a nuclear interacting particle is given by 2i plus 1, where this I value can be calculated by its multiplicity. So what is there, since pi have a multiplicity of 3, okay, it is having a multiplicity of 3. So here we put 3 is equal to 2i plus 1 and we can calculate the value of I. So calculating the multiplicity, we can calculate the value of I. And for each I state, for each multiple states of the group, we have an integral electronic charge for that particle and the isospin component, the iz component or the ith component for a particular particle. I was the spin for a particular group, whereas the isospin is for the particular particle of that group. So we can calculate the iz component, that is called the isospin for a particular particle by the group, by the formula that iz is equal to qp minus q bar. What is qp? Qp is the charge on the particle. It is having a positive charge, negative charge, and we know that the charge is in the multiple of the electronic charge. So qp is the charge on the particle and q bar is the average charge on that particular group of particles. So if we want to calculate, there are two particles, protons and neutrons. We don't have to calculate in the group the antiparticles, we just have to take the particles. So for the nucleons, how many particles are there? 2. So we had the formula 2i plus 1. Here we had the formula 2i plus 1 is equal to multiplicity. So multiplicity is 2 here. So 2i plus 1 is equal to 2. So this 1 comes here. So we get 2 minus 1 and this 2 gets divided. So I becomes 2 minus 1 by 2. So what is the formula? I takes the value of half. So I is equal to half will be both for proton as well as for the neutron. So this is the column for the isotopic spin and this is the isospin, that is the zth component of the particular particle. So here you can see that half is taken by the particle as well as its antiparticle. But the calculation will be done only for the particle and the same value of I is taken for the antiparticle. So proton and neutron both have the I value. So you can see here both have the I value as half. And the antiparticles also take the value of half because that for the antiparticles again they will form a two-membered group and again the value will come out to be half. So this is how we can calculate the value of I for a particular group by calculating the multiplicity. So now since in the nucleons we had only proton and neutrons, so we have to calculate the Iz. For Iz we want Qp and Q bar. So Q bar is average charge, that is the charge on proton plus charge on neutron divided by 2 since there are 2 particles. So charge carried by proton is 1, charge carried by neutron is 0. So it is 1 plus 0 by 2 which is equal to half. So average value of the charge on this group is half. And Iz, what is Iz? Iz is Qp minus Q bar. So we will put the individual value of the charge value of the particular particle and the average value. So I have written IZP. IZP means the isospin of the proton particle. So that is one proton has one charge, one positive charge, and the average value Q bar is half. So 1 minus half is half. We get the value of IZ for proton is half. So you can see here for proton the IZ value is plus half. Similarly, if we calculate for the neutron value, so neutron will have a charge of 0. And the average value was half. So it is 0 minus half is minus half. So Iz value for the neutron is minus half. Similarly, we can calculate for the proton, antiproton and for antineutron. So antiproton will have opposite charge and antineutron will be having the zero charge. So but it would be having this one. So you get minus half and plus 1. So whatever is the I value for the particle, the Iz value is reversed for the antiparticle. So it was for proton, it was plus half. So for antiproton, Iz value is minus half. For neutron, it was minus half. So for the antineutron, the value of Iz is plus half. Similarly, if we carry our same calculations to mesons, so in mesons, what is the multiplicity? We have 3 particles, pi positive, pi negative and pi 0. So here it is 2i plus 1 equal to 3. So 3 minus 1, 2. So 2 divided by 2 is 1. So the I value comes out to be 1. So you can see here for the pi's I values are 1. And to calculate the average value, so average value is for pi positive 1, 0 and minus 1 divided by 3 number of particles. So 1, 0 minus 1 by 3 is 1 and 1 gets cancelled. We get a value of 0. So 0 by 3 is 0. So average value of the charge on this pi group is 0. So let us calculate now Iz. So Iz for the pi positive will be, for pi positive charge is 1. So 1 minus average value 0, that is 1. Similarly for Iz pi negative, we get minus 1 minus 0 which is minus 1. And for the Iz pi naught, you get 0 minus 0, that is 0. So you get for I positive it is 1, for neutral it is 0 and for pi negative it is minus 1. Here please don't get confused because the pi minus is coming in the antiparticle of pi positive, but in the multiplicity in the group we always state that pi's come in 3 types, that is pi positive, pi negative and pi neutral. So multiplicity for pi is 3. Similarly we can calculate for the k, eta, lambda, sigma, xi, omega. You can take the calculations. One more calculation to you. So let us calculate for sigma naught. So for sigma naught comes into two types, that is sigma naught and sigma minus. So multiplicity is 2. So multiplicity is equal to 2i plus 1. So 2 is equal to 2i plus 1, which implies that I value is equal to 1 minus 2 minus or 1 divided by 2, which is equal to half. So I is half for sigma naught and sigma minus. So you can see here I naught is half, 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 and half here. Now let us calculate the Iz value. So what is the average value of the charge? So charge average value 0 minus 1 upon 2, which is equal to minus half. Okay, is that clear? Now the charge Iz component. So Iz is Qp minus of Q bar. So for if we calculate for the Iz of neutral, so charge is 0 minus Q bar is minus half, so value is plus half. So you can see here for naught it is plus half. And similarly, if you calculate for the I negative particles, so it is minus 1 and minus of minus half. So it will be minus 1 plus half, which is equal to minus half value. So for sigma naught, the value is minus half, and the antiparticles have opposite. So sigma positive is the antiparticle of sigma negative. So minus half, it is positive half. And since sigma naught bar here is having the value of plus half, it will have minus half. So in this way, we have calculated the spin and isostropic spin and isospin for the cascade particles also. And for the minus charges, you can also calculate. So in the neutral charge, since there are three type of particles here, in the eta naught, lambda naught, and here, so there is only one neutral charge, so there is only one component also. So if the multiplicity is just one particle, so you can calculate the value of I. So I value comes out to be 0 by 2, which is equal to 0. So here you can see eta naught and lambda naught both have the values of 0, and since the charge on the particle is also 0 and the average charge will also be 0, so the isotropic spins will be also 0 and 0. So these are the charges. And similarly for minus also, the charge on the particle is minus, average charge is also minus, so both gets cancelled. So again you get the isotropic spin and the isospin values as 0 for omega minus and omega plus also. So in this way we can calculate the rest of the values. So now let's calculate the next parameter, that is the strangeness quantum number, that is the S value. It is also sometimes regarded as strangeness. So who were the ones which gave the strangeness quantum number? So that was that behavior of the particle, the strange behavior of the particles was predicted by, was given by, proposed by the two scientists Gell-Mann and Nishijima. So Gell-Mann and Nishijima had observed the strange behavior of two particles. They had observed the strange behavior of the K mesons and the hyperons. So all the four hyperons were strange particles, and in the meson family only the K type of mesons showed the peculiar behavior or the strange behavior. So we have to remember that in the strange particles we have K mesons and the hyperons, and these were regarded as the strange particles, and they were assigned some quantum number, and this strange quantum number was called the strangeness. So why were these strange particles? Because these strange particles were produced in high energy nucleon-nucleon reaction. When proton-proton-proton-neutrons were interacting with each other, then only these type of particles were created, and the strong interaction has a decay time or a nuclear time of 10 raised to power minus 23 seconds. But when these strange particles decayed, they decayed in the weak interactions, and the weak interaction had a time of 10 raised to power minus 20 seconds. So the decay time was very, very small. As soon as they were created, they were just decayed down to other elementary particles. So it was observed that these strange particles were always created and they always decayed, they annihilated in pair, they created in pairs. So they were produced in pair, and the strangeness number is zero for all the rest of the non-strange particles. Only the strange numbers are carried by the K mesons and the hyperons, whereas all other elementary particles carry the strangeness number as zero. So the value of the strangeness number is calculated by this formula. So this formula is QP. QP means the charge on the particle. Somewhere it is written QP, somewhere it is written just Q. So QU mean that it is the charge carried by the particle for which particle you are calculating the strangeness number. So QP is IZ plus S plus B upon 2. So what is B? B is the baryon number. If the particle is belonging to the baryon family, it is possessing the baryon number. If it is a particle, its baryon number is plus 1. If it is an antiparticle, the baryon number is minus 1, and it does not belong to the baryon family, then the baryon number is 0. S is the strangeness number, IZ is the isospin value of that component of the particle, and Q or QP are the charge on the particle. So by substituting the values, we have already calculated the B value. We know what is the isospin value, we know the charge on the particles. So there are 4 parameters involved in the calculation of S. So 3 parameters are known, so we can calculate the 4th parameter, that is the S value. So here you can see, so Q is equal to IZ plus S plus B upon 2. So let us calculate some strangeness value. So I am writing here QZ plus S plus B upon 2. So let us, since the pi mesons and eta mesons are not strange particles, so directly we can write the S value as 0. Now let us calculate for the K positive. So K positive strangeness number we are calculating. So charge carried is 1. IZ value we have calculated. So IZ value is half. So a half plus S plus. Since it is not in the baryon family, so B value is 2. So 1 minus of half is half into 2 is equal to S. So means that S is equal to 1. So the strangeness value is 1. Similarly, we can calculate for other factors also. Let us now calculate for the sigma value. Again, sigma value is again having the same thing. Let us calculate now for sigma naught. So sigma naught, charge on the sigma naught is 0. IZ value of sigma naught is 0. Plus S plus B upon 2, and B value is 1. So 0 is 0 cancels. So S plus S is equal to minus B, which is equal to minus 1. So the strangeness on this sigma naught is minus 1. Similarly, if we calculate for sigma positive also, let us calculate for sigma positive. So sigma positive, charge value is 1. IZ value for sigma positive is plus 1, baryon number is 1 divided by 2, so 1 minus 1 is 0, so again you get S is equal to minus 1. So you have the value for sigma positive, you have the strangeness value of minus 1. Similarly, if you calculate for negative 1, you can also calculate it for sigma minus. So sigma minus, the charge is minus 1. You can see the IZ value is minus 1 plus S plus, again baryon value is 1 upon 2. So minus 1 gets cancelled and S is equal to minus 1. So for whole of the sigma family, you can see that the strangeness number is minus 1 and the antiparticle will have a positive sign, that is the opposite number. You can similarly calculate this also for the values. Okay. Charge carried is for sigma positive, bar will be minus, and the IZ value is minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 gets cancelled. So S is equal to, again, minus B, but the baryon value is, for the antiparticle it is minus 1. So minus minus gets positive that side. So you get a value of positive 1. Let's calculate for omega now. Or let us calculate for omega minus. So omega minus we have क्यू इज इक्वल टू आई जेड प्लस एस प्लस बी अपॉन टू. सो चार्ज ऑन दिस इज माइनस वन. आई जेड वैल्यू फॉर नेगेटिव इज जीरो. एस प्लस बेरियर नंबर इज वन अपॉन टू. सो इट इज माइनस टू इज इक्वल टू एस प्लस वन. सो एस इज इक्वल टू माइनस टू माइनस वन विच इज इक्वल टू माइनस थ्री. सो फॉर ओमेगा माइनस द स्ट्रेंजनेस नंबर इज माइनस थ्री एंड फॉर ओमेगा पॉजिटिव इट इज प्लस थ्री. सिमिलरली इफ यू कैलकुलेट फॉर द कैस्केड वैल्यूज द वैल्यूज आर माइनस टू एंड प्लस टू. सो इन दिस वैल्यू एंड फॉर द लास्ट हाइपरबोल दैट इज लैम्डा नॉट यू अगेन गेट अ वैल्यू ऑफ माइनस वन एंड प्लस वन. एंड वी हैड ऑल्सो कैलकुलेटेड द वैल्यूज फॉर द के टाइप ऑफ मीजोन वेयर फॉर द के पॉजिटिव एंड के नॉट इट वॉज प्लस वन एंड फॉर इट्स एंटी पार्टिकल द वैल्यू वॉज माइनस वन. सो नेक्स्ट वी कैलकुलेट द हाइपर चार्ज क्वांटम नंबर. सो वी हैड कैलकुलेटेड अवर फोर क्वांटम नंबर्स. न्यूक्लियन क्वांटम नंबर विच कंप्राइज ऑफ द न्यूक्लियन नंबर, अवर लेप्टॉन क्वांटम नंबर एंड द बेरियन क्वांटम नंबर. देन वी कैलकुलेटेड द स्पिन क्वांटम नंबर. देन वी कैलकुलेटेड द स्ट्रेंजनेस क्वांटम नंबर, आइसोस्पिन, आइसोटोपिक स्पिन एंड द लास्ट वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग द हाइपरचार्ज क्वांटम नंबर. सो हाइपरचार्ज क्वांटम नंबर इज जस्ट द एडिशन ऑफ द प्रीवियस क्वांटम नंबर्स वी हैड कैलकुलेटेड. सो हाइपरचार्ज इज गिवन बाय 2 इंटू क्यू बार. क्यू बार इज द एवरेज चार्ज ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर ग्रुप of particles. Or q bar is also, as we know in the isotopic spin, I was equal to q minus q bar. So q bar will be I minus of q minus of iz. So y is equal to 2 into q minus of iz. So here what we'll be having, and q minus iz in the formula of the previous one we had also calculated, where q was equal to iz plus s plus b by 2. So q minus of iz is equal to s plus b upon 2. So 2 into q minus of iz is equal to s plus b. So in place of 2q minus iz we can substitute s plus b. So y is what? Y is nothing but y is equal to s plus b. So either we can calculate the value of y as s plus b, or you can calculate the value of y into 2q minus of iz, or we can calculate y is equal to 2q bar. So we had drawn two columns in this chart for the calculation of y. One by y is equal to 2 times q minus iz, or one from the y is equal to s plus b. So you know that the leaving only the k meson and the proton neutron, these are non-strange particles. So the S value is 0. So for the pi meson and the eta meson, your S value is 0 and the baryon number is also 0. So you get the hypercharge value also 0. But in the case of the proton, since the strangeness is 0, but the proton carries a baryon number as plus 1 minus 1. So the hypercharge for proton neutron is plus 1 and for the antiparticle it is minus 1, because the antibaryons have minus 1 value. So now let us come to the K type mesons. So K positive, K naught. So we have the charge on K positive is plus 1 and the iz value is half. So if we put here for the K positive, so y is equal to 2, q is 1, iz is plus half. So it is half into 2 is 1. So the k value is 1. So you can see here the k value is plus 1. And if you talk in terms of s plus b, s is plus 1, baryon number is 0, so it is plus 1. Similarly, we can calculate for k naught and their antiparticles. So we have calculated the y values. Similarly, for eta naught, it is non-strange particle. S is also 0, b is also 0. And charge is 0, iz is 0, so everything comes out to be 0. Proton neutrons also we have calculated the hypercharge values. So next come to the sigma positive. Sigma positive charge is plus 1. Charge is plus 1 and the value of the iz value is 1. So 1 minus of 1 is 0, so 2 into 0 is 0. So the hypercharge value is 0. And if we calculate by s plus b, s value is minus 1 and baryon value is plus 1. So, minus 1 plus 1 is 0. Similarly, we have here also. So, we can calculate it for sigma positives and their antiparticles. Similarly, if we look for the cascade naught and cascade minus. For cascade naught, if we have the cascade naught, so we can calculate for cascade naught value. It is 2, charge is 0. You can see the Iz value. Iz value is plus half. So, 0 minus of half. And here it is minus half. So, 2 into minus half will be minus 1. So, you can see for cascade naught, the value of y is minus 1. And with s plus b, s is minus 2. So, minus 2 plus 1 will be minus 1. Again, minus 2 plus 1 will be minus 1. But for the antiparticle, s is having plus 2. Baryon number is minus 1. So, 2 minus 1 is 1. That is positive 1. And for the omega particle is having s value minus 3. And the baryon number is plus 1. So, it is minus 3 plus 1 minus 2. So, here we can calculate like this, something like this. So, this is very easy to remember. So, in this way, we have shown in this chart the type of the particle, their antiparticles, the baryon numbers. We have listed the spin, the isotopic spin, the isospin component, the strangeness number and the y value, hyperchart value, that is calculated by two methods, by using the formula of 2 times q minus iz and y is equal to s plus b. So, this is very, very important. So, please remember this table and meet you again. Thank you.